show, man. I mean, I'm thriving, shining. Look at these.
So my hair is natural all my life up until I was 7 years old. That's when I got my first perm. I think I only had one. And then my grandma was growing my hair out. Then skip forward to 8th grade. I got my second perm. And that's what we're going to be going through. Also, at this time, I started dyeing my hair really bad. And I was also always straightening my hair. Like, I never gave my hair a break. I was still straightening. Then eventually I stopped getting perms and just kept straightening it. And that's what you're going to see. And then eventually I stopped getting perms and I started seeing I had a curl pattern, which was in 8th grade.
So I tried myself getting some Garnet Fruit Teas scrunching powder, gel or whatever, and just started scrunching my hair and flattening my bang out.
I knew I was natural. I had a pretty curl pattern. I just didn't know how to go about it. So fast forward, this is my 10th grade year. In August, I started getting braids. And I was getting macro braids just to help me grow my hair out. And so I wouldn't have to do it. So, you know, it was kind of easy. And then in the next picture is when I had bit chopped finally. So I was transitioning. Then I had finally bit chopped. And then I'm a year into me being natural. Everything's fine. I'm loving it. And then this is the summer, right as I was going off to college. And I had dyed my hair blonde. And then that summer going into sophomore year, I had dyed my hair blue. And I kept it blue till it faded out to teal. So that was a pretty color. I loved it. And then after a while, I eventually, I was trimming my ends every so often or whatever, but I finally did cut it again. Well, my first time really cutting it. Everything else, I really don't consider me cutting it for real. And then fast forward, my hair, this is like 2015, like my birthday, December. And that was like the growth I had from that. So I didn't really record any progress in those 2 years. And then, like, after my hair grew, like, this was the 2-year result of that. And then, here we go. I dyed my hair once again. Every 2 years, it seems I always dye my hair. So, I dyed it red. I loved it. It was actually a pretty color. And it was different because I had never did red before. And I did, like, a little wash and go with it. And then, like, here's a better picture of my wash and goes. Like, that was always bomb. And you see how they had my red eyebrows to match with it. And, like, dude, my hair was still fine. It was still thick. But I was doing slip backs. So my hair, my edges were really struggling. My fault, of course. So I have been wanting to dye my hair like a real, real blonde. I've done blonde a couple times, but I want it platinum blonde. So now I'm going through the process of trying to color remove it and get all this orange, reddish tint out my hair. And it's working, but you see my curl pattern was messed up. It was still thick at the time, so I wasn't really complaining much, but I could just tell a difference in my hair. I have 4A, 4B hair, and like my curls were thin and just stringy. But what I do, I still want to dye my hair to a blonde. That was my first attempt at trying to go platinum, that color, and it didn't turn out very good. So then I went and bought some more dye that lifts your hair up to 6 levels. And needless to say, it definitely got my hair the platinum color I wanted. Not the one I needed, but overall, I liked it, and this time, like, I could see my hair was really thinning out just because I kept dyeing my hair so much. Like, I was just sick of it, and I was just going through my own personal issues, so I decided to cut my hair, and I remember that day, so I cut my hair, and I liked it. I felt free, but I was also bald. So I won't really feel that too much. I'm giving you bald head auntie vibes. You know, who's doing bald head whole shit. You feel me? Nah. But, so, my hair, I'm not used to my hair being so short. And my hair is really thick short. Of course, it's thick and long. But that's a different type of thick when it's short. Like, ooh.
I can really tell, like, my kinks and curls when it's really short. When it's long, like, of course, your hair stretched out. So, like, I had to relearn my hair over again. It was kind of easy at the beginning. And now, like, woo, she does what she wants to do. I had got the bright idea, I'm going to document my hair journey, like, from me cutting it. So I started my a thread on Twitter about, like, my 7 years of being natural. So I started that last year before I had decided to make a YouTube channel. So right here I'm going through, like, my whole 7 years of me being natural. And then, like, I start to track my progress of me cutting my hair. So that's literally what you're going to see in the pictures, is like from when I cut my hair on to now, just a very shorter version of it. So I do have a video on how I grew my hair out within a year. I'm really not going to talk about that too much since there's already a video on that. But as you can see, I did dye my hair again. And that's still the color I have in currently. So I've had this color for a whole year. And I've slowly been cutting it out. And I don't plan on dyeing my hair right now. If I am, it's not going to be permanent. I don't know. I just hate that every 2 years I just start to dye my hair. And that's really my big issue. I want to dye my hair. I want to straighten my hair. So now I'm starting a heatless and colorless hair journey. So within all the years I've been natural, within the last 5 years, I've only used castor oil. That's been a staple. Other than that, like, my hair products really switch up. Like, it would be under budget projects, but I still switch up. I never stay with one thing. And I was using Cantu when I first went natural, but I don't use it no more. And I can explain why. And if you knew, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And if you're not, welcome back, Pooh.